Today, we look at the window air conditioner in the RV and some of the problems with this. One of the great things about it is these units require a lot less electricity to run, so they are easier to find places that we can plug in the RV and actually run these air conditioners. Now, one of the big problems back in 2014 when they started doing this that we found was you pull in, you park the camper. If your camper was level or a little off level, sometimes water would run back into the camper. Well, we found out that if we parked the camper with the air conditioner down side downhill from the other side of the camper, that this wouldn't happen. The water would run out like it's supposed to. The only other problem that we found was after a weekend of camping, especially if there was a lot of humidity, that when we hooked the camper up and started down the road, guess what? We got water inside the camper because all the water was still in the pan, and when you started down the road, it actually sloshed it out the front. So it basically leaked back into the camper. So there was a couple of thoughts on how to fix this problem. And I'm going to share with you today the way that we fixed a lot of these when they first started doing this to get rid of the water problem, or to help get rid of the water problem. Okay, so the first thing that you got to do is you've got to go around, you got to take all the screws out of the cover that covers the AC. And once you get the screws out, they use butyl sealant behind this. So what you have to do is you have to take a putty knife and you actually have to work it in behind this to get the sealant to release. Okay, so once you get the cover off, the next thing we want to do is we want to measure the opening from here to here, and we want to mark the center right here. I put a piece of masking tape on here so that I could mark the center. You also want to measure from the bottom up 1/4 of an inch and put a mark on there. Now what we are going to do is we're going to drill a 1/4 inch hole through the sheet metal. Okay, the next step, once we have everything marked, is we want to take our putty knife and we want to stick it in between the condenser and the sheet metal and make sure it goes clear down. We do this to protect the condenser when we drill the hole so that we don't drill a hole into the condenser. Okay, once we have the hole drilled, we can take our putty knife out. Kind of look up through the hole there and make sure that you can see up inside there. The next thing that you want to do once you have the hole drilled is take the masking tape, and I actually took the sticker off also. I'm going to take some spray paint and you're going to spray paint the hole. I put paper in here to help keep the overspray off of everything else. We want to paint this hole to help protect the exposed sheet metal from. Okay, the next thing you want to look at while you're in here is where the metal pan and the side of the trailer come together right here. You want to make sure that this is caulk good. If there's any gaps or anything in there, you want to use a good silicone rubber and you want to caulk between the plate and the side of the camper so that water cannot get through there. Okay, once you get everything done, then what you want to do is put a little bit of butyl on the back side of the cover, any place that it doesn't look like it'll seal up, and then line the cover back up and start and put all the screws back in it. Now when you tighten the screws down, you only want to snug them, you don't want to tighten them. The cover's plastic, it won't take a lot of torque. Okay, so that's how we modify the air conditioners to help get rid of some of the water. Does it help? Yeah, it does help. It gets the water level a lot lower in the pan. You see, you don't have the water coming out inside the camper. Does it hurt the efficiency of the air conditioner? I don't believe it does. These little window units in these small campers does such a great job of cooling. I don't think you'd ever notice if it does change the efficiency of it. Hopefully this helps you out if you have water problems. We've done a bunch of these and it definitely does help. I hope this helps you out. Next week, stay tuned. Next week we're going to take on a Dometic three-way refrigerator, and we're going to do some mods on it to help it cool a little bit better. So tune in for that. And thanks for watching, and please subscribe. We'll see you on the next one.